The red-knot Rufa is a shorebird that breeds in the humid tundra. There are 6 subspecies, each one representing a distinct population. Each population follows its own migratory route, or flyway. In early April, the red-knot Rufa departs from the southern tip of Argentina en route for the Canadian Arctic, where it reproduces in early June. Though the weather conditions are harsh and food is less abundant, there are fewer predators at this latitude. For the red-knot Rufa, the long migration represents a survival strategy. There is a correlation between the population cycles of predators and their prey. Populations of birds of prey and lemmings go through ups and downs together, in a cycle that repeats itself every 3 to 4 years. These population patterns are called biological cycles. To compensate for the decline of such primary prey as lemmings, some predators may turn to the red-knot Rufa as a food source. A clutch of eggs begins to hatch at the beginning of July. The adult females usually begin flying south a few days after their eggs have hatched, thus avoiding the migrations of predatory birds that will be taking the same flyway a few weeks later. Unfortunately, the same cannot be said for their young, who will have to contend with these predators during their own migration. The females will remain a few weeks ahead of the others all the way along the flyway. In some years, harsh weather conditions may limit the number of eggs hatched. Without any young to care for, the males may take flight at the same time as the females in search of a location where food supplies are more abundant. It's instinct. It's time to go. First stop is the Mingan Archipelago National Park Reserve. The yield of primary productivity of the marine environment can impact the richness of the flats. This biodiversity and abundance of food is a primary asset for the Mingan Archipelago. Upon arrival, the red-knot Rufa undergo a series of physiological transformations. They will double their weight within 2 to 3 weeks. The body parts that are responsible for flying, such as the breast, the back muscles, and the heart, will undergo a period of atrophy in order to make room for the feeding-related parts of the body, such as the gizzard, stomach, liver, intestines, and leg muscles. The muscles related to the gizzard play an important role as they allow the red-knot Rufa to crush the shells of the mollusks that are part of its diet. The bird becomes an eating machine. Amongst the benthic wildlife of this archipelago, the red-knot Rufa can feed and gain the necessary weight for their next migration. In order to increase their chances of survival against predators, the young learn the importance of moving in flocks across the vast flats and of staying away from the vegetation surrounding the islands. Moving as a group, both in the sky and on the ground, is fundamental. Such clumped distribution allows the birds to maintain a heightened awareness of predators, thus reducing the chances of any one bird being caught. The red-knot Rufa population has dropped by 70% since the year 2000. Of the 53,000 birds estimated in 2000, only 16,000 remained by 2010. Researchers around the world have united their efforts to learn more about this endangered bird. At the Mingan Archipelago National Park Reserve, researchers use the capture, mark, recapture method to obtain detailed information about the remaining red-knot Rufa population. The flag's color helps to identify the location of the initial capture. White for Canada, green for the United States, and orange for Argentina. In the future, other researchers will be able to collect data from the red-knot Rufa without having to recapture them. Certain birds, especially juveniles, about whose movements and ecology little is known, are outfitted with geolocator devices. Near the end of their stay on the Mingan Archipelago, the red-knot Rufa have sufficiently augmented their fat reserves for their long flight ahead. However, they must first undergo another transformation, which lasts approximately 3 days. Those body parts needed for flight recover, so that once again, the bird becomes a flying machine. The red-knot Rufa encounters few protected areas along its flyway. A great number of obstacles exist throughout its long migration. Human disturbances represent a major threat to its survival. Urban and tourist developments near red-knot Rufa habitat have been a major source of disturbance. These disruptions can prevent the bird from feeding properly in order to gain the necessary fat reserves to survive its long migration. Thanks to an international effort to create awareness and better understanding of the bird's decline, collaborative efforts have been undertaken to help the red-knot Rufa's population. With the help of geolocator devices, researchers have discovered that certain red-knot Rufa are able to divert up to 1,000 kilometers from their paths to avoid heavy storms. As a result of global warming, tropical storms are stronger and more frequent. Global warming has also increased precipitation levels, which means increased snowfalls in the Arctic. This makes it harder for the red-knot Rufa to find good nesting conditions. The birds sometimes have to move to a higher latitude in search of better conditions, which leaves less time for breeding once they arrive. Sometimes, it's impossible to reach these higher latitudes, and weather conditions prevent the birds from producing offspring. While the adults have migrated to Tierra del Fuego, which means land of fire, at the southern tip of Argentina, the young red-knot Rufa will spend almost a year on the Atlantic coast of Brazil. The following year, some of the adults en route to Tierra del Fuego will make a short stop in Brazil. The young red-knot Rufa will take this opportunity to accompany them once they resume their migration to Argentina.
Tudo bom?
Estou numa boa. What's new with you?
We just avoided two storms. Makes for a long flight, but I've seen worse.
So, Tierra del Fuego, is that like Mingan?
Well, it's not a protected area. You need to be on your toes in Argentina. There are much more human disturbances to watch out for.
Them again?
Yep, our population keeps dwindling, and these scientists strongly suggested that we should be identified as an endangered species, you know. Argentina is the only place along our migratory path where we're all together in one place. Makes us easier to count. Everything they learn about you will help other researchers, no matter where you end up.
What's all the commotion about?
I'm one of the oldest Rufa here, thanks to my flag. They've been following me for 17 years, not to mention that I've flown more than 500,000 kilometers. That's further than going to the moon.
Wow.
In the Delaware Bay, researchers have found a strong link between the red knot Rufa and the horseshoe crab, a living prehistoric arthropod. The horseshoe crab's eggs are an important source of food for red knot Rufa. Unlike mollusks, these eggs have no shell and allow the bird to feed even with an atrophied gizzard. However, overfishing of horseshoe crabs in the 90s has decreased the available egg supply. Since 2007, it has been prohibited to catch horseshoe crabs in New Jersey. Barring any further threats, the population should be able to recover, although this could take time, since it takes on average 10 years before a horseshoe crab is mature enough to lay eggs. Red knot Rufa arrive in the Canadian Arctic to breed in early June. They feed on seeds and grass as they await temperatures that will trigger the hatching of spiders and insects. In some years, favorable weather conditions help the red knot Rufa find nesting areas that are ideal for their needs. Areas which are devoid of snow and the right size for a nest. Areas which offer enough ground cover to camouflage them from danger. After the eggs are laid, both male and female will share nesting duties for the next 22 days. The eggs hatch just in time for the season's insects to emerge and provide extra food before the bird's departure. In early August, when the young birds are able to fly, most of the males will leave for the Mingan Archipelago National Park Reserve. A few males will remain with the young for an additional 1 to 3 weeks until they are ready for their first migration. Human disturbances are greatly reduced in protected areas such as those managed by Parks Canada. These havens provide wildlife with suitable habitats and protection from human threats. Furthermore, the research that is conducted in the Mingan Archipelago National Park Reserve is part of an international initiative that allows scientists to better understand the ecology of this remarkable bird. In fact, the Mingan Archipelago is the only destination on the Red Knot Rufa's itinerary where we can get an indicator of breeding success. Whenever a bird bearing an identification flag is spotted, scientists scour existing records to determine the sex of the bird. The arrival of both males and females around the same time in the Mingan Archipelago is an indicator of a poor reproductive year for the Red Knot Rufa. However, when females arrive in the Mingan Archipelago first, to be followed by the males 3 weeks later, this indicates a good reproductive year. Such occurrences gives us hope that the red knot Rufa population will recover one day.